Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Excel 65. We're live in Grand Forks, North Dakota. And ladies and gentlemen, it is the final episode of Excel before our mega event coming up next Friday night. High Voltage, which will be live in Indianapolis, Indiana. Tonight in our main event on Excel 65, it will be an explosive tag team match as you will see Edward Elric and Joe Higashi team up to take on the other formidable team of television champion Crowd Strife and the Rave Master Haru Glory. That and also we will have two Royale Rumble Switch matches to give the XL brand a little bit of an early run when they have to get ready for the Royale Rumble after High Voltage. All that and more tonight on Excel 65. And speaking of 1/4 of the main event, here he is, the Rave Master, Haru Glory, who will be a part of that explosive triple threat match for the XL Championship next Friday night as XL Champion Akuma will defend that title against Edward Elric and Haru Glory. A lot of people have a lot of investment riding into it. As you look at what happened last week, Akuma just attacked Haru Glory with vengeance and wrath. Look at this. Brimstone through the Japanese announce table. Haru Glory was out. This is during the whole time that Edward Elric even came out with Tenchi Masaki on stage. So we do know that Tenchi Masaki has supported at least the XL champion Akuma and Edward Elric. But what is the actual plan? What is the actual end game for Tenchi Masaki not only being here on XL, but also trying to court Edward Elric and Akuma? I'll tell you, he's trying to expand the dynasty. He's trying to expand his faction, the Juraian-Saiyan Alliance, to not only just take over Impulse, which they already have done, but do it on XL as well. Let's listen in on with Haru Glory and what he has to say. Heading into High Voltage. Glory rallying the troops. Haru Glory not going to allow Excel to go down like Impulse. And wait a minute. Wait. Damn it! He makes me physically ill whenever I see him on screen at this point. He is such a profound liar. He should run for president next year. Nah, I take that. That can't happen. The JSA already has the Impulse title. They cannot get the XL title heading into High Voltage. They can't. If the XL Championship happens to jump ship with the JSA, there may not be a damn entity, individual, or soul out there that can stop this unholy alliance.
Join
ACW social media experience by first of all visiting Facebook to get all the latest news, information, and other items pertaining to ACW. Also, visit our Twitter page where you can get all the official live feed news and bits to get you by the day that is ACW. Visit our YouTube channels, our main channel, and our Mega Events channel to watch all your favorite shows, Mega Events, newscasts, and other videos at hand. And also, visit the ACW Wikia, chronicling the background, history, and information that you need to know to be the ultimate ACW fan. Visit the ACW social media experience on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and at the ACW Wikia. Stay cool. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Excel 65. Let's take you back to last week as Bamido took on Wave. And during that match, Lubok took out an unconscious Genji and brought him out to distract Bond. But that would not be enough. Tatsumi with a chair shot, taking out Genji, which allowed Bond to get distracted and beaten by Wave heading into High Voltage for the Excel Tag Team titles. Tony, that wasn't funny! Well, Tony's always had a lack of humor, so anything's funny to him. He actually thinks the John Cena meme is a funny thing, too. So that should tell you where his humor sense is, but yeah. People gotta hire sometimes. Anyways, let's focus on what's about to happen right now. In our opening contest here tonight on Excel 65, as Momochi Zabuza makes his way out to the ring here, you are going to witness now a Royale Rumble Switch match. Now, for those that have been following Impulse lately, they have been doing Royale Rumble Switch matches in terms of determining the numbers that the Rumble participants will be drawing at the Royale Rumble on October 23rd. Zabuza's opponent is about to make his way down to the ring. There's the legendary Donkey Kong. Always a clear favorite whenever these type of mega events roll around. Donkey Kong, with his longevity, experience, and his size and power, he's got to be a clear favorite if you're talking about him being a part of the Excel Rumble match. We will go over the so far official participants that have entered their claim or entered their spot to be a part of the Excel Rumble this year. So we'll go over that one. We will go over that list in a few moments during this telecast. Now, for those that don't know what a Royale Rumble Switch match is, let me just fill you in for those that haven't been keeping up with Impulse lately. On the Excel side here, it's the same rules apply as it does on Impulse. With a Rumble Switch match, is basically, if you are able to defeat your opponent, then your number will get a better drawing than it normally originally has been stated. And vice versa, if you lose your match, your number will get a bad drawing. So say like if you're number 10 and you won, you might get your number now as number 13, number 16, or maybe even number 20. And then vice versa for the losing portion of the match, it would have to be, if you're number 10, you could be like 6, 3, or you might even start out the Rumble as number 1. So keep that in mind here as we head into the Royale Rumble matches here. As we start things off here, Donkey Kong has Zabuza up and drops him down with the sidewalk slam. Still to come, folks, Hiei will go one-on-one against Kinnikuman in another Royale Rumble Switch match. And Zabuza with a boot, and Donkey Kong counters with that tilt-a-whirl slam. And then also in our main event on Excel here tonight, before High Voltage, next Friday night, Haru Glory and the television champion Cloud Strife team up to take on Edward Elric and Joe Higashi. That is an explosive main event there. Here's the cover, Zabuza's foot under the ropes. Donkey Kong now working onto Momochi Zabuza here with those big punches. And look at this. Zabuza goes up and gets dropped on the ropes throat first. Big headbutt. That will kind of rock Zabuza a little bit. Donkey Kong and Momochi Zabuza. Not strangers to each other at the least. Here's the cover. One, two, and a shoulder up by Zabuza. Yeah, but these two have a lot of history here. It was Momochi Zabuza, actually, that was the one to defeat Donkey Kong. When Donkey Kong arrived in 2008, he was undefeated until he met Momochi Zabuza. And that was when Momochi Zabuza, here's a cover, Momochi cover one, kick out by DK. That was when Momochi Zabuza broke the undefeated streak of DK. And I believe, if I can recall, that was at ACW Fusion in 2012. I believe so. I'll have my staff get on that. Russian leg sweep by Zabuza. Takes down DK. I want to address something that happened before the commercial break. I mean, Tenchi Masaki coming out here. We now know why he has a clear invested interest in this Excel Championship Triple Threat match coming up at High Voltage. He wants the Excel title to come to the JSA. Now, for those that have been following Impulse, the JSA hold every single title on the Impulse brand, the Impulse side. Gohan's the Impulse champion, Solid Snake is the Intercontinental champion, Raditz and Nappa are the Impulse tag team champions, and Goten is the Cruiserweight champion. That is all JSA territory with those belts right now. And now Tenchi's trying to put his influence on the knee to the face by Zabuza. Now he's trying to put his influence onto Excel slowly but surely, and starting at the top here by going after the Excel championship. And here's the cover by Zabuza. One, two, shoulder up, and you can tell he's covering his bases. He courted Akuma and he courted Edward Elric, and wow, an Elric there, and DK's bleeding. But Zabuza was able to court Akuma and Elric. Now, I don't know if Akuma or Elric has accepted those offers Tenchi made recently on Excel, but I you know, you may not be the biggest fan of Akuma, you may not be the biggest fan of Elric, but you would want to hope, you want to hope with all hope involved, that they do not defect to the JSA. I mean, I'm looking at Elric, and I don't like his attitude as of late, but he's kind of gone off as some type of rebel. You know, rebel without a cause. And for Edward Elric to just sell, for all the talk he's been talking about with ACW, some justified, some obviously not, and then to just go ahead and join the JSA, that makes no absolute sense whatsoever. DK with a clothesline takes Zabuza down. And then you got Akuma. We're talking about the legendary Akuma here. He's a fighter at heart. His tactics are underhanded and his tactics are plain despicable, but he's still a fighter. You're telling me Akuma's gonna sell his soul, well, again, to the JSA? I'm not buying that either. I don't know. Maybe Elric and or Akuma have agreed upon it. Maybe they haven't. There's a lot of confusion going on here in ACW Excel. And one other thing that was not even really mentioned, but I noticed before I could even say it as we went off the air last week, there was no signs of the Blue Spirit last week, if you recall. We've seen the Blue Spirit appear on Excel recently in terms of getting involved with Edward Elric, Akuma, and Haru, and there was no sign of him last week. So I found that odd, but maybe for the better. As DK now coming back with some punches, and Zabuza blocks it. Big Sandal takes down DK. The sandals are hurt, I tell you what, they poke your eye out. Look at this, chin lock here. As DK is struggling. Now granted, if you want my honest opinion, I would rather have Haru win that title over Edward Elric and Akuma. Especially now knowing Edward Elric and Akuma have had some sort of talks with Tenchi about joining the JSA. You can't risk that title going to the JSA at this point. I'd rather have Haru. Love him or hate him, Haru's the better option in terms of keeping that title to the ACW brand. It's DK now. Trying to come back after that Tilt World Slam. Irish Ribbon knocks down Zabuza. DK had a pretty nice run at the 2014 Excel Rumble last year. It was eventually eliminated. And obviously, competing in the Switch match, he has entered to be a part of that the Rumble. And oh, clothesline from hell! From Zabuza. Cover. 1, 2. DK still got it. And that clothesline from hell takes no prisoners. It does not discriminate towards anybody. That will do the damage. Momochi Zabuza. Oh, and that big sandal sends DK over the top rope. Momochi Zabuza, he's trying to get back to the mountain that he once was last year. He was competing for the XL Championship when he won the gauntlet. Oh, and another big sandal knocks down DK. And you're talking about the former Turbo Champion as well. You know, he wants to be able to get back to the XL title picture, and this time actually win the XL title. Irish Whip's DK back in the ring here. Zabuza taking too much time taunting the crowd, not focusing on DK, but DK still struggling to capitalize himself. DK now from behind turns him around. Irish Whip to Zabuza, no fakes it, and a headbutt takes him down. Good matchup so far between Zabuza and DK. That's to be expected. Look at this. Zabuza's up here. No Zabuza counters. Look at this. Have DK up for a backbreaker. I think Zabuza may be calling in for the Kenjutsu onto DK. He's done it before. No, and it won't happen again, however. DK now. Irish with Zabuza to the corner. Zabuza sent down it. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh no, that's a big man! That's a big creature! Oh! Zabuza being squashed with all that body. With all that weight. And it might be time for a jungle shuffle to end it. Jungle shuffle! No! Zabuza countered it with a drop toe hold. He saw that coming from a mile away. DK pushes back. Still tries to get into the match here. DK, he's got it hooked in! Zabuza! Jungle hijinks onto Zabuza! He got it in! Zabuza didn't see it coming. Cover! 1, 2, and 3. And DK is victorious. Oh boy. So DK will have presumably a better drawing than he did originally here tonight. As DK, one of the clear favorites to potentially win the XL Rumble this year, has to feel pretty proud of himself for his performance here tonight. Take a look at the final few moments here. Jungle Shovel was countered into a drop toe hold. Now Zabuza was trying to capitalize. DK somehow found the strength to push back Zabuza and capitalize quickly with the jungle hijinks. And DK would then eventually go over the cover. You see the instant replay from different angles of that jungle hijinks. And then DK went for the cover. That was it. Zabuza had no answer. The Royale Rumble is shaping up to be very interesting as we are on the road there very soon. Speaking of which, our official theme song for the Royale Rumble this year is Pressure by Youngblood Hawk, which is available on iTunes now. Now let's take a look at the participants on the Excel Rumble here this year for the Excel brand this year. Take a look at it. You got Choji, you got Mr. MVP Dan, Team Star Fox, DK, Hiei, Kakashi, Straight Cougar, Zabuza, and Kinnikuman. Plus, at the Excel Rumble, we'll have their own three mystery opponents. You see there's still open spots in that Excel Rumble match, which will all be probably filled up as we get to the road there. So that's going to be very interesting. But wait a minute. Now, what is this all about? Well, this is pretty unscheduled, but apparently we're going to be joined by the Glamour X champion, Ino Yamanaka, with Deanne not too far behind her, as Ino Yamanaka will look to enter her 10th month as Glamour X champion, as she will defend that title once again against Reiko Hinomoto at High Voltage next Friday night. Will Ino Yamanaka be able to retain the title? Can Reiko finally defeat her? And now we're going to have to hear. Man. Damn it. I kind of agree. Oh, that was weird. Ooh, can't argue with that either. I'm agreeing with Ino too much. Ino Yamanaka being very bold with those words. Oh boy. That'll bring out the Zero Fighter, and she's not alone with Asuka Kazama and Samus Aran on her side here. Oh, this is about to get very interesting here. Rico's now got the microphone. I have never seen Reiko as serious as she is right now. Oh, man. Oh, man. Reiko Hinomoto making the definite statement towards Ino Yamanaka. Reiko Hinomoto more determined than ever to win that title next Friday night. Can she get the job done? Or will Ino find once again to retain that title?
Oh,
back to... Holy crap. Here we go. Well, I was going to say, welcome back to Excel 65. And you see Samus and Remy blown here at the parking lot here tonight in North Dakota. Oh, my goodness. Roundhouse kick. It looks like we're not going to wait till high voltage for these two ladies to see who's going to knock each other who out here tonight. This rivalry has gone for more than half a year between Remy and Samus, dating all the way back to Animania 3 week last year. And now Samus and Remy will look to solve their final encounter between one another at high voltage in a match where you have to knock out your opponent to be the victor. And that what an appropriate match to have. These two hate each other. These two cannot stand each other. These two cannot be within the same vicinity as Remy, just throwing punches onto Samus. Samus trying to come back. Clothesline Samus down. Oh my goodness, and look at, oh no, oh my God. Oh! A DDT onto the concrete. Not many can survive an attack like that. And now Samus throwing Remy towards the barrels there. Punch to the midsection. Oh, this is gonna be ugly. And a knee right to the face. And on this night, Samus puts down Revy. Will that be the same result heading into high voltage? Woo! You can feel the fever pitch just at an all-time high right now on Excel 65. And we're not even close. We're not even near Indianapolis. Not even close. What else can happen here tonight? Oh my goodness. That was a brawl. I shudder to think what Revy and Samus will put themselves through in a KO match. That will be next Friday, as right now we get to our next contest here tonight. Hiei will participate in his Royale Rumble Switch match. Hiei, for all this time that he's been in ACW, has not been able to win a singles title. Maybe that can change if we're able to win an Excel Rumble this year and go and fight for the Excel Championship at Animania 4. But this will be his opponent here tonight. The legendary, the revered Kinnikuman. I tell you something, folks. Kinnikuman is one of the biggest icons in all of anime, a staple in Japanese culture, and also in wrestling culture, if you want to be completely honest. The likes of Hulk Hogan, and the likes of Great Muda, and even Nakamura, even today's wrestling fan, they all understand and appreciate the impact Kinnikuman has brought. And Kinnikuman wants to cement his legacy as one of the best ever. If he were able to win the Excel Rumble this year and have a better drawing, if you will, than he did last year. But I will say this, though. I mean, going back to the Excel Rumble last year, as you see here in Kinnikuman, this is a Royale Rumble Switch match once again, but, you know, for those that forget, Kinnikuman last year, he had an amazing performance at the Rumble. I mean, the Excel Rumble. I believe, if I do recall, and a lot of ACW historians will double check me, because, you know, I forget a lot of things, but Kinnikuman, I believe, was one of the last six. It was with either the final six or the final eight of that Rumble. He went there for a long time. I believe he was there for about 25 to 30 minutes in that Rumble match. So it's possible that Kinnikuman could even do better and win the whole thing. Because I do recall he had an amazing Rumble performance. But that was then, and this is now. As Kinnikuman and he are locking up into some chain action here. Side headlock by Hiei. Kinnikuman brings him back with a front face lock. Turns into a wrist lock. And Hiei now reverses into a hammerlock and pushes him back. Hiei, look at this, Irish whip onto Kinnikuman to the corner. Dropkick. No, Kinnikuman moves out the way. Kinnikuman waist locking behind. Clothesline. Hiei ducks. Kick to the midsection. Hiei now. Irish whips. Kinnikuman ducks over. Kinnikuman comes back. Oh, and an overhead lariat. Great sequence there by Hiei. Kinnikuman is Hiei now. Irish whips Kinnikuman here. Oh, and a counter with a neck breaker by Kinnikuman. Another neck breaker. Looks like Kinnikuman wants to focus on Hiei's neck here. And look at that. Runs Hiei over the top rope. Could be a little bit of a premonition heading into the Royal Rumble on October 23rd. And Hiei knows better. Hiei's not stupid. He's not going to rush head on back into the ring with Kinnikuman in control. He's going to take a breather, play some mind games, play his type of game. Still to come here on Excel. Probably up next, I believe, after this match, it'll be the main event here tonight on Excel 65 as Joe Higashi and Edward Elric will team up to take on the television champion Cloud Strife, Haru Glory. That is going to be a very explosive match. TA's taunting the crowd here. I mean, this could be just him playing mind games, but, I mean, the referee is counting and we're almost halfway to the 20 count here. And Kinnikuman, four onto the face. Screw a knee, you will respect the elbow. Elbow. Okay, I'll stop. Hiei still, and Kinnikuman's had enough. Kinnikuman now coming outside to bring Hiei back into the ring. I'm gonna say enough already. He's stalling here, but it didn't work really. Now Kinnikuman, throws a double axe onto the chest of Hiei. Look at this now, Kinnikuman backbreaker onto Hiei. Look at this. Oh man! Another double axe him to the back. Tell you what, Kinnikuman has just great in-ring talent here. Look at this quick cover here by Kinnikuman. One, two, and a shoulder up by Hiei. Kinnikuman, his legacy is already cemented, a first ballot Hall of Famer, if I've ever seen one. Kinnikuman, one of those talents that come in a lifetime. His influence, his charisma, his legacy, his career, his talent. They're very unmatched with a lot of people. I think Kinnikuman, look at this. He has Hiei up here. Hiei got out of it. Hiei. Whoa, German onto Kinnikuman. That was quite impressive. And a spinning heel kick sends Kinnikuman down. Now Hiei will tackle down the leg, but as I was trying to finish up before he just pulled that off, Kinnikuman, I believe he would want to, you know, before his career is over, you know, he's probably one of the tenured members in ACW, not in terms of his career here, but in terms of wrestling in general. But you know, Kinnikuman, he's getting up there with age. Let's be honest here, folks. You know, Kinnikuman looks great in shape for a guy his age, but he's getting up there. Now, eventually those talents are going to start having a few little miscues here and there. Your influence will start to be forgotten with the new audience and a lot of that in between. So I think Kinnikuman, he's looking at this XL Rumble match and he wants to be able to win a title, more specifically the XL Championship, before he calls it a career. Because as you see, there's new talents just coming around. Here's a Hiei cover. One, two, and a kick out from Kinnikuman. As I was saying, there are a lot of new talents here on ACW, on the Excel brand, and even on the Impulse brand. And they are going to be taking their spots. They're not going to be asking. They're not going to be waiting. They're just going to take you now. You see that with the likes of, unfortunately, the JSA with certain members. You see that with Night Raid on the Excel side. So you see a lot of talent. You know, they want to be able to showcase their potential right now. They don't want to wait for another year or two. And Kinnikuman, I don't think he wants to give up that spot, but you know, if he's not able to hang on tight enough any longer, his spot will be taken too. That's just the nature of evolution. TA now. Knee dragged, dropped right onto the mat. This Kinnikuman has been pretty much dominated by Hiei working on the leg so far during this match. Very useful for Hiei as he just nailed another overhead lariat. Look at Hiei going back towards the leg once again. Some smart strategy because Kinnikuman likes to go for the Kinnikuman Buster, which requires a lot of lower body strength, and can't be able to do that if you have one leg at least. And look at that, Hiei once again tackling on the leg here, trying to make Kinnikuman a three-legged table here, if you will. Look at that, Hiei again working on the leg. Even though you may not be able to submit him right now, he's right now doing damage to that leg to where Kinnikuman is going to have to shake it off and apply pressure to it. That's Kinnikuman, and Hiei counters that high elevated lucha arm drag. And Hiei might be calling for the third eye here. Look at this third eye. He's got him up. Whoa, Kinnikuman with a nice counter. See, I'm telling you, Kinnikuman, very skilled. Very, very skilled. Clothesline missed, however. Hiei, another overhead lariat. Those overhead lariats so far in this match have really done a number for Hiei. Now Hiei's up top. Kinnikuman's up. Kinnikuman caught Hiei. Fall away slam. Down goes Hiei. And this could be where Kinnikuman gets back his momentum in this match, because he desperately needs it so far. Kick to the midsection. Hiei's back up. Kinnikuman's got it. Counters. Belly to back. Down goes Hiei. Look at this, Hiei though, still in this fight and this on the mind. Look at this. Oh, look at that! Reverse DDT. Almost lost the grip there, but it was effective. Spinning wheel kick. Completes it. And now Hiei. Looking to finish off Kinnikuman. Maybe possibly with a third eye. But Kinnikuman still has enough life in him to fight here. Kinnikuman sent over the top rope. And brings Hiei back. Been a good matchup so far between Kinnikuman and Hiei, as we all knew it would, but Kinnikuman maybe looking to end it. No, Hiei counters Kinnikuman's grapple attempt, and a wow! Face crusher, bulldog, whatever you want to call it, it was effective. Now Hiei dragging Kinnikuman away from the ropes here. Now what? Oh, look at this. Hiei going back to the leg here, this time applying a single leg crab onto Kinnikuman. Now, luckily for Kinnikuman, I believe his upper body can still crawl him over to the ropes here. But how much has that leg been in pain? Will that pain be too overbearing for him to overcome? It looks like Kinnikuman is struggling so far, as Hiei's got a clinch. You see Hiei's right arm here just wrapped around that injured leg. And look at this, Kinnikuman now crawling to the nearest rope in front of him. He has no choice, and he does grab the ropes. But has it been too late? Is it too late for Kinnikuman, as Hiei now? Look at this, oh my goodness! Back suplex! I'm very surprised right now with Hiei's strength. It's very, very appreciative. I just don't like the man. Now Hiei. Oh no, look at this! Oh! Haru Karana off the top turnbuckle! Flawless! Hiei up top! And a moonsault! No! Double knee to the midsection! Kinnikuman played possum! And now Kinnikuman! This could be the time! This could where the tide shifts for Kinnikuman to get back into this match! He has him up! And Hiei once again gets out of that maneuver and DDT's Kinnikuman! Hiei found a way to counter Kinnikuman's momentum once again! This could be third eye time! And no, Kinnikuman with his own DDT counter! But Kinnikuman holding his ribs now, he knows that he's gonna have to finish this match very soon. Or else Hiei will somehow find a way to win this Royal Rumble Switch match. Kinnikuman back up. Look at this, Kinnikuman Buster, no! Hiei countered into a neck breaker! Kinnikuman is right back up, but Hiei quickly! Oh no, he's got him locked in this time! Hiei! Third eye! One! Two! Three! No! No, 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 Kinnikuman! He's still in the game! It's still in this match! But Hiei is clearly in control. He is looking to capitalize and finish Kinnikuman off with a swift victory. And Kinnikuman counter power bomb. How does Kinnikuman still do it, folks? I'll tell you why, because he's Kinnikuman. And Kinnikuman, he's got Hiei up. Kinnikuman Buster! Kinnikuman, the cover. One, two, three. What? Two? Buster. There are not a lot of people that will kick out of a Kaneku Buster. But Hiei just did. That's how you can tell how determined he is to win this Rumble Switch match. This tells you how much Hiei wants to be able to win that Rumble match for the first time in his career. But Kinnikuman will be that roadblock, because he wants it just as bad. As Kinnikuman still working on Hiei's neck here. Oh, there's the eye rake. And Kinnikuman, surprise roll up. One, two, three, he got it! Kinnikuman got it! Kinnikuman got the surprise roll up victory! Kinnikuman has defeated Hiei. Oh my goodness, what an extraordinary matchup between Kinnikuman and Hiei. Two men that are determined to win that Excel Rumble because they want to be the ones to main event and Mania 4 for the Excel Championship. We'll take a look at the highlights here. Look at that Hurricanrana on the top turnbuckle, which will lead into the third eye by Hiei. And he went for the counter, but Kinnikuman somehow was able to kick out. And then Kinnikuman went for the Kaneki Buster. But that only got him a two. And here's the final few moments here. Hiei went for a grapple, but Kinnikuman somehow, someway was able to go for a roll-up. And that was all that Kinnikuman needed to get the victory here tonight. Wow. As we head on to the road to the Royal Rumble, these matches are only going to get more intense. Congratulations go to Kinnikuman.
September 25th, every title is on the line. Hino Yamanaka defends the Glamrex Championship against number one contender Reiko Hinomoto, Night Raid, in the Get Back Brawl for the Goodstone Tag Team titles. Joe Higashi against Cloud Strife, Television Champion, in a ladder match. It's a triple threat frenzy as Akuma defends the Excel title against Haru Glory and Edward Elric. ACW proudly presents High Voltage Live, September 25th, live only on YouTube and Vimeo.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Excel 65. The main event is in just a few moments here on Excel 65, but we are going to go over the official High Voltage Mega event coming up next Friday night. Our official theme song will be Would You Still Be There by Of Mice and Men off their album Restore and Force, which is available on iTunes right now. Now, for the ACW Direct portion coming up earlier next week, this has just been announced, it'll be a Royal Rumble Tag Team Switch match. Kinnikuman and Kakashi will take on Hiei and Choji Akimichi in a Royal Rumble Switch match. I cannot wait for that one personally. We will find out who will have better standing or even worse standing. But let's take a look at the official card. These two ladies hate each other, and they will look to finally settle it in their possible final encounter as Samus takes on Revy in a KO match. Which female will be the last woman standing, if you will, in this matchup? And then also, the tournament finals comes to this point. We will crown new Excel Tag Team Champions as the Get Baggers take on Night Raid. Which two members will represent Night Raid, and can the Get Baggers overcome the odds that favor the Night Raid crew? We will find out next Friday night. Then, Reiko Hinomoto gets a second chance at the Glamrex Championship that Ino Yamanaka holds. Will Ino Yamanaka head to month 10 still the champion? Or will Reiko Hinomoto realize her dream and become the Glamrex Champion and put the division on the map, as she said here earlier tonight? And then this matchup here, Joe Higashi takes on the Television Champion Cloud Strife for the Television Championship in a ladder match. Joe Higashi wants the best Cloud in his own game. Will he be able to get the job done? Will Cloud retain the title and defeat Joe Higashi once again? But then the main event, Triple Threat Anarchy. Haru Glory, Edward Elric, Akuma for the Excel Championship. With the influence of Tenchi Masaki and the JSA and the Blue Spirit's whereabouts, what is going to go down in this main event matchup? Who is walking out the Excel Champion in Indianapolis, Indiana? It's High Voltage, where every title is on the line, live, this next Friday, September 25th, only on Vio and YouTube, here in Indianapolis, Indiana. You cannot afford to miss the final Excel Mega event of the year. Man, you look at that official match card and you're like, what am I really doing important next Friday night that I have to miss High Voltage? And that's a legitimate question. And you know me. That'll be next Friday night. This is here, this is now. It is now time for our main event of the evening. And I tell you what, this is an all-star studded main event if I ever seen one. As Joe Higashi is in the ring as he awaits his tag team partner. The self-proclaimed best in the world, the self-proclaimed hottest commodity in CAW, is walking down to that ring with a mixed reaction from the crowd. There are some fans booing him, and there are some fans cheering him. Because for the past couple of months, Edward Elric, like I stated earlier here tonight, has become a rebel without a cause. Some look at him as a charismatic leader, and others look at him as a compulsive liar. Either way, there is some type of reaction that Edward Elric gets from the people whenever he steps inside. But will all that carry him to his first ever Excel Championship at High Voltage next Friday night, when he takes on the current Excel Champion Akuma and a former Excel Champion in Haru Glory? Will Edward Elric realize his dream to be at the top of the echelon in ACW finally, after a 9-year stay in ACW, to become Excel Champion? And now here comes the opponents. And the crowd here in North Dakota on their feet for the television champion, Cloud Strife. Cloud Strife has held that title since Fusion this year, when he defeated, of all people, Edward Elric. Then he defended his title against Joe Higashi at Ground Zero and won it, which will lead to their rematch at High Voltage in a ladder match. Now we await for the final participant in this match. Crowd here in North Dakota, on their feet for the Rave Master, Haru Glory. I tell you something, Haru Glory, in my opinion, like I stated also earlier tonight, he's probably our best bet in terms of keeping the ACW Excel Championship away from any JSA possibilities. You can hate the man, or you can like him, but the fact of the matter is, they cannot be really denied here. Haru Glory is one of the best that ACW has ever seen. Someone that started from the bottom, not to steal a drink quote here, but one that started from the bottom and rose to the ranks in ACW, which eventually saw him win his first ever Excel Championship at Animania 2. He defeated Moroku the Monk. Former Excel Rumble winner. He was the Excel Rumble winner in 2008 as well. Haru Glory still wants to accomplish a lot here in his career. Can he be able to become a two-time champion next Friday night? He's got the possibilities to do so. Bell has rung, and here we go. Your main event here tonight on Excel 65. Haru Glory and Cloud Strife against Joe Higashi and Edward Elric. And Joe just tagged Edward Elric. We already know Joe Higashi doesn't want any part of Cloud before High Voltage. That's pretty obvious, as here we go. Like I stated a few minutes ago, it was Cloud Strife that defeated Edward Elric at Fusion for him to keep the television title that he now holds. Look at this. Edward Elric. And look at Joe Higashi now. Now he wants to tag. Now he wants to be in the match. Oh, look at this, Cloud Strife. Butts heads. Tail goes Elric. And dodge to Joe Higashi clothesline. And now Cloud will get his hands on Joe Higashi. Joe Higashi will have to deal with Cloud Strife here tonight. Drop kick. Joe Higashi picked the stipulation when he defeated Cloud Strife in non-title action a few weeks ago on Excel. But instead of picking a match that would have favored him, I could say a submission match or an Iron Man match maybe, Cloud Strife, he was able to choose a stipulation that Cloud Strife would be more suited for in a ladder match. To beat him at his own game, in Joe Higashi's words. We'll see if that can occur at High Voltage. There's an Irish whip. Look at that! Overhead hip toss by Haru Glory. Haru Glory, one of the main staples of ACW. Here's the cover. One, two, and a kick out. Haru Glory. When you ask new fans of ACW who were some of the people that helped create ACW to become what it is today, Haru Glory has to be mentioned within that group. That's Haru Glory now. Look, there's no Joe Higashi. Elbows to the face onto Haru. And here we go. And there's one German suplex. Not surprised. Kick to the midsection. And Haru gets snapmared from behind. And look at that big knee to the face. He's trying to break Haru's nose. I don't know if it's any worse than John Cena's, but pretty close. Oh! Double back toss by Higashi and Elric. And Elric now is going to take advantage of Haru Glory. History between Elric and Haru this year alone is already documented. As Haru Glory defeated Edward Elric at Ground Zero, the last Excel mega event that we currently had. And look at this, Elric with a big boot right to the face of Haru. Here's the cover, but I believe Haru's got the ropes, and he does. And also the same Edward Elric that for weeks and months has said certain disparaging remarks about Haru Glory's career and personal life. Certain people have made a decision. Oh my goodness! Full Nelson Slam for the win, apparently. But as I was trying to say, a lot of ACW fans have made up their minds in terms of what Elric said about Haru. There's a nice lariat by Elric. Some agree with that Elric had none to lose, so he told the truth. Others figure that Elric is a liar and that there probably weren't any true accusations towards claims. I'm not here to confirm or deny either way. I don't know Haru Glory's personal life like that to really judge, but those are some damning remarks. I mean, everybody knows those remarks by now, so I won't repeat them, but it's been a pretty rough few months and weeks for Haru Glory, with the exception of his Ground Zero match with Edward Elric. It's been a rough year. You know, any man couldn't be able to take that kind of pressure. He couldn't be able to take that kind of abuse. moonsault. Higashi with the cover. Haru's foot under the ropes there, but Higashi is still in control. Look at that nice snap here with the arm, and look at that! Leg drops it right on there. And you know Higashi, he's gonna be looking to put in that padded armbar of his to take out Haru. Now Elric tagged back in here, and Elric now gonna go to town on that arm as well. Edward Elric, arguably one of the most decorated wrestlers that ACW has ever had in its 9-year history. The first ever Road to Destiny champion, a 2-time television champion, the first ever double champion holding the Road to Destiny championship and the television title at the same time, has competed. Oh, look at this, Rave of Destiny. Oh, elbow to the side of the head there. And look at that, oh, DDT by Elric. Has main evented Animania before for the Impulse title. Elric has done it all except win the big one. Now granted, Elric has seen, you know, that success in other leagues, but in specifically in ACW, he has not been able to win the big one here. As Haru's come back with some clotheslines, Elric counters with the roll-up, one, two, and Cloud breaks it up. And good on him. Now Haru is coming back with, no, Elric with some punches of his own. Now Haru now coming back with punches onto Edward Elric and takes down Elric. And Elric once again with another roll up. One, two, and Haru once again gets out of another surprise Elric roll up counter. Oh, that's Haru, Ring of Destiny, and Elric able to counter out with an elbow to the side of the head. And now Haru dazed, doesn't know where he is here. Elric, and once again, another DDT, only that time, Haru Glory busted from the forehead. And now Higashi will take control, and Higashi will go back on that arm that he's been working on towards Haru this entire match. You can tell all cylinders are fired. Oh, look at Haru with a roll-up. One, two, and Elric breaks it up. And a spinning wheel kick sends Haru down. And Cloud has had enough, but Higashi with an enziguri. Here's the cover. And Cloud again breaks it up. And Cloud is going to get a German for his troubles. But Haru capitalizes from an unsuspected Higashi with that overhead neck breaker. Higashi pushes. Oh man, that roundhouse kick! Even though I'm sure Chuck Norris is not jealous or anything, I would not doubt Chuck. And look at this! Haru, one! Two! Oh, that kick out! Oh, these close encounters, folks. And now Cloud is in the ring here. And look at this, Haru and Cloud gonna go for a double maneuver here. And look at that! Double suplex! And Higashi goes down. This may be the opening that Haru needs to get the victory here. And Higashi rakes the eyes of blood. He's got it, the counter suplex. Down goes Haru. Here's the cover. One, two, and Cloud breaks it up again. Oh, all four of these men. Oh, look at this, Haru. You can't see him with that punch. Oh, he's about to make sure you definitely don't see him this time. And the crowd really chanted that. But still, Haru Glory. Stood off his shoulders. Five knuckle shuffle. And now Haru could be set up for the Rave of Destiny. This could be it. Rave of Destiny. He's got it locked in. Rave of Destiny onto Higashi. This match is over. Wait a minute, Elric. He's in the ring here. He is in the ring. Edward Elric preventing Haru from capitalizing. Electric chair drop. Sends Haru down. Damn it. Let's do this again here. Haru Glory had that match won here. And then look at that electric chair drop to prevent Haru from stopping. We're back live right now. Elric is finally tagged in legally here. Oh, man. Higashi got his ass saved by Edward Elric. I'll tell you that. We got another big boot. Sends down Haru. Haru bleeding profusely from the forehead. Edward Elric, self-proclaimed best in the world. You can argue for a lot of things for Edward Elric. Look at that, Haru Glory holding his arm very, very noticeably. The damage has been done. But Edward Elric! Alchemy! He got the alchemy onto Haru! But Haru somehow grabbed the ropes! And for his own benefits, he did it well! But Haru's still fighting here! Haru's up top, bloodied and defeated as all! He's still fighting here against Edward Elric! Haru going up top! Oh, man! A leg drop, but that arm is really starting to affect Haru Glory. Haru may need to get attacked to Cloud Strife. Oh man, that arm is looking like it's going to the worst pain ever. Spinning wheel kick! And Haru's still up, but Edward Elric is in control. Oh my god, a flapjack! And now Edward Elric. Oh man. Oh man. He hits this, it's over. He hits this, it's over. Edward Elric, holy crap! He got him! The Reign of Destiny, he nails it onto Elric! He got him! He got him! All Haru's gotta do is go for the cover! And wait a minute, Cloud and Higashi out the apron here, and look at this, Cloud and Higashi brawling outside here, in the ring, outside of here, and look at that, Higashi and Cloud taking the brawl to the ramp. Those two meet in the ladder match at High Voltage next Friday night, and it looks like we're not going to have to wait until these two really get their hands on each other. Cloud Strife and Joe Higashi trading blows towards each other here. Wait a minute. Holy crap. Party is over indeed. Oh, man. That only means one thing. For whom the bell tolls, Haru Glory, when he blocked Akuma's attack, Haru Glory title shot onto Akuma! Haru Glory avoided an ambush from Akuma, the champion! Haru Glory has been through them enough times to know better! And now Haru fighting Akuma head on! And the crowd on their feet here for the Rave Master! For the man that can become a two-time Excel champion by next Friday night! The possibility is there! Haru Glory can see it! Overhead neckbreaker, I believe it was on the title! Look at this! Look at this! Haru Glory determined to become Excel champion once again! You can't see him, Akuma! Dirt off his shoulders! Five knuckle shovel! Akuma's not bleeding! Haru Glory stalking him like a vulture! He's gonna kick him up! He's got him up for the Wave of Destiny! No, Akuma! He got out of it! Oh, there's a big boot! And now Akuma's got the title! And now Haru Glory has been taken out for the title! And this is not good! Oh no! Oh no! Just like last week! The brimstone onto Haru Glory! Sickening! And now Akuma! He's gonna toss Haru over the top rope here. Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Edward Elric with the title! Oh my god! Elric just took out Akuma with the title! Oh, and he dropped to hold him on his own title! Edward Elric is not taking any chances! The 9-year journey of the Full Metal Alchemist can see its fruition at High Voltage Alchemy onto Akuma! For many people, it could be Edward Elric's time to finally win the big one! The spear takes down the champion! And Elric's got the title! And one more belt shot for good measure! Edward Elric has put down the demon, the Excel champion, and Elric is celebrating to a crowd mostly receptive. Could this be the scene that we see at High Voltage in Indianapolis? Can Edward Elric finally get the title that has eluded him for 9 years, the Excel championship? Can the Full Metal Alchemist realize his dream?